What's up? I'm Adam.
I'm Patrick.
And I'm Will.
Will is here to educate us on Data Activator inside of Microsoft Fabric. And wait, before you go anywhere, we know a lot of you are just using Power BI, and that's okay. Will's got something for you from a Power BI perspective. If you've been using Power BI for a long time, you may recognize that smashing face. Tell folks who you are and what you do for those that may not know.
Thank you very much for having me here. My name is Will Thompson. I'm a group product manager for this new thing called Data Activator. And I spent 6 years or so doing Power BI stuff, a bit of visualizations, a bit of modeling. And about a year ago, we saw this as an opportunity for this new product, and we needed somebody to go and lead the product side. So I thought, hey, why not? That sounds like a great opportunity for me to grow and learn. And so I've been driving that for the last year or so.
What is this Data Activator and why? Why is it important to me?
It's a way for people to start linking the insights and the cool things they find in their Power BI data to some actions. So when you find something in your report and you go, ah, that's really weird. I didn't realize that my sales were declining in that place. Or you go, oh, I didn't realize that we had a problem with package deliveries in that city. I need to go do something. I need to go change the way I run my business, change operations in my business. Data Activator can help bridge that gap.
You know, Will, don't take offense to this, but it's kind of like the alerts that I could set up on a dashboard.
Patrick, I like that you bring that up. For everyone watching, in the comments below, put hashtag dashboard if you actually use the dashboard feature in Power BI. Not talking about a report that you made look like a dashboard. You're actually using the dashboard item. So just segment, continue.
So that feature that's been around in dashboards for a while, really useful if you want to do some really basic alerts in a dashboard. We all know most people are using Power BI reports today, and alerting on the data in those reports you have not been able to do. A Data Activator can help there as well, that we can set up these alerts on top of the data that's in those reports, keep watching those reports for you, watching the visuals in those reports.
It's like Big Brother.
No,
it's like Big Brother. Okay, I got it. I like this. I think it's phenomenal, but you know, we like to do a guy in a cube. Enough of all this talking, Will. Let's head over to your laptop.
I'm going to start off with something super, super simple. So I've got a report here, actually, that's using some data from the bikes that are available for rent in London. So if anybody of you visited London, you can probably tell from my accent I'm from the UK.
I would have never guessed.
The people who run these bikes, they actually make the data available through an API. So we're connecting to that data, bringing it into this Power BI report. So I'm combining that real-time data about how many bikes are available in each street, each docking station, with other information from our data warehouse and other places. For these bike stations, how occupied are they? How much empty space is there for people to leave bikes, and how many bikes are available? And if I was going to go and check this report on a regular basis to make sure that we're distributing the bikes around London properly, that's going to take me some time to keep going and monitoring that report. The Data Activator can help here. What I need to do is come to the visual that I care about and choose this trigger action option from one of these charts. And now we can create an alert. So all I need to tell it is, what do I want to measure? What's the conditions that I'm looking for? And then we'll set up the action that I want to take. So in this case, we want to measure this occupancy rate. We're going to say for each of the streets. You can see like the filters and slices from the report, all of the context from what you selected in the report. All being applied to this alert as well. So it understands all the things that you've been looking at. And then we can say, how often do you want to go check this data? Most people's Power BI reports probably refresh once a day, so you probably only need to check it once a day. But if you've got more real-time data like this, check it every 5 minutes.
Wait a second. Are we talking real-time or near real-time?
We'll go and check it for you once an hour or down to every 5 minutes.
Okay.
So if your data is faster than that, yeah, it's near real-time.
Okay.
We'll come back another time to talk a bit more about like real-time. And then we say, hey, what's the alert that you want to check? What's the threshold that you want to look for? So you can say when it becomes greater than something or goes below a threshold, changes from or to a different value. In this case, I want to know when it becomes greater than, let's say, a threshold of 80%. So when there's 80% occupancy, which means we're running out of space in that docking station, so people won't be able to put a bike back when they get there. You know, I need to say, where do I want to save this alert? Because we're going to save this as an item back into your Fabric workspace. And I'm actually going to choose a different workspace. And so what this is going to do, this is going to create what we call a reflex. When you think about what Data Activator is doing, it's listening for that stimulus, that data coming in from that Power BI report. And it's taking a response. It's this stimulus response system. So we've created this reflex item. And the reflex is where we store, you know, what are we connecting to? What are the things that you care about? And then we'll go and look at the actions. We create these triggers, which are monitoring this data, looking for these conditions, and driving some actions as a result. All right, so this is what's got created. And we can see here's that same data that we're monitoring pulled in from Power BI. And this is going to keep getting refreshed every 5 minutes, like we were saying. We can see it's looking for when does that value become greater than 0.8. And you can see actually over the last few hours, there were 3 points here where for Duke Street Hill and Snowfields, you know, there were too many bikes in this place. So this is showing us what would have happened if this trigger had been running. And then at the bottom, you can see it's sending me an email. So this is a super simple alert that's going to go send me an email, but I could do other things as well. I could go send a Teams message instead. So I can put in things like, you know, type the headline. So there's, you know, too many bikes, and I can add in some extra information if I brought in some more data. But everything looks good here. I can even go send myself a test alert just to make sure that this data comes through and that the alert.
You got to validate stuff, right?
Got to validate it. You got to check this stuff, right? Okay, you can see my test action just arrived. Talking there's too many bikes. And it's pulled out just one of the values from the last time that this alert would have fired. So you can see it's Duke Street. I'm ready. It's monitoring my data. I don't need to go look at that report anymore. Data Activator is going to handle it. We're all about making people efficient with their time.
If I'm working for a hospital, we have an emergency room, right? We have a number of beds. Maybe we have a report that's monitoring the number of beds. If I'm working for oil and gas industry and I'm monitoring like telemetry on gauges and things like that, I mean, it's been some good use cases to kind of proactively monitor those where somebody's just not waiting, right? Sending alerts.
And customers come up with different things all the time. In retail, you know, monitoring store sales, you know, I want to go and kick some kind of campaign off if we see sales declining. Grocery stores where there are freezers and kind of monitoring the temperature of those freezers.
Ooh,
and
then,
moving food out before it goes
We don't
down.
Want the ice cream to melt. It's my ice cream reflex.
As you get to these kind of really granular use cases where you're thinking about monitoring very specific and quite detailed operations, there's always some latency kind of involved in doing that because you're batching that data up and aggregating. You want to do these things in more real time. You know, you want to be reacting as soon as a user takes that certain journey through an application. That freezer scenario, right?
Yeah.
If I've got an IoT sensor, as soon as it goes over that temperature value.
While I appreciate soft serve ice cream, that's not what I want out of the grocery store. All right. So Will, I got a question. Like, how do people actually start using this? Are there requirements that are there that need to be in place in order to leverage this?
This is already in public preview. So anybody who's got a Power BI report in a Fabric capacity that's in a supported region, you can go try it out. You'll see it on that little dot menu. Now, as a Fabric admin, you can turn it off. So if you don't see it, go check with your admins first. You do need a workspace with the daemon. It doesn't need to be where the Power BI report is. We can monitor reports in a different workspace, but the reflex item that got created needs to go into a daemon capacity.
Okay.
Totally, the first thing to do to get started is go try it out, right? Dead simple, go to your Power BI reports, .. menu, trigger action, fill out the thing. Over the next few weeks and months, you'll see that pane is going to get simplified as well. We are working really hard on making this a super, super simple experience. For
you're just going to make our video out of date, and we got to re-record once that happens.
That's how Will's making
sure it can come back.
So you will see changes to it, but we really want to hear that feedback as well.
Yes.
I would love if everybody who goes and tries it also gets on the community forums, on the ideas forum, and let us know what you think.
Thank you, Will, for being here with us. And thank you everyone for watching. Let us know in the comments below what you loved or what your questions are, and we'll follow up on it. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.